Hey, what's up, everybody? So today I'm going to be talking with Brian from Being Alive. He's one of the facilitators here for the ceramic studio. And for you guys that have been watching my YouTube channel and reading my blog, you know that this ceramic studio, well, not this particular one because it's moved, this particular program was very, very important to me when I was first diagnosed and also homeless on the streets. So it's funny, I'm doing this thing on my YouTube channel and my blog called What Are You Thankful For? I'm grateful for, and I'm actually grateful for this studio. So this is Brian. He's one of the facilitators here at Being Alive Ceramic Studio. Tell me something about the ceramic studio.
Well, we can share the name of the organization as well, right? Being Alive. Yeah. This is Being Alive. Ceramic Studio Workshop was created as part of the wellness program with Being Alive. Okay. And it was created to, one, to get a lot of the HIV-infected people out of their homes, to get them out into a public place, but more importantly, a safe public place. Where they can socialize and produce art at the same time.
And not be hidden away.
That's right. Both of which are very therapeutical, whether you do each one by themselves, but the social aspect and then the creative aspect together, especially being around other people who are in the same situation, mm-hmm. It's just, it just feels good.
Now, what I notice about this, because I go to HIV support groups and then I come here, and this just works for me better because it's not clinical. I don't feel like I have to talk about my status, but I think it's cool that I'm with other people who are HIV positive, and we're all really just focusing in on the art, and
right.
HIV is like a backdrop.
Right, and that's what's
instead
nice.
Instead of HIV being right. the focus.
And that's what's nice about it. Even though it's an HIV AIDS organization, this is all about the art.
Right.
And if HIV comes up in conversation, it comes up. But then if it doesn't, it's not such a big deal. Right.
And that's what it should be. That's what HIV, it should be like, big deal.
We're just artists sitting around and appreciating each other's work and what we have to offer to each other.
Right. So how long have you been doing this?
I've been doing this for, since 2002. 7 years.
Wow. And how long have you been with Being Alive?
I've been with Being Alive for about 4 years.
Okay. And the new setting is, I like the new setting because it's kind of campish.
Yeah,
a day retreat.
We moved from a small enclosed space, which can be very dusty sometimes when working with clay.
It smells like cat pee too. Well,
that too, but I wasn't going to bring that up. But more importantly, though, a lot of us guys, including myself, I get pneumonia very easily. So if I can be in a well-ventilated space, such as being outdoors, it's just better for me and my health. Cleanup is a dream because everything goes back into the earth when we clean up, so that's pretty nice. And we have it tarped off so we're not sitting in the heat. And you're right, I call it camp. Our studio camp, and that's exactly what it feels like. Yeah.
So let's talk about some of your pieces right over here.
Do you want me to pick it up and bring it over?
Yeah.
Be careful. Don't pick it up like that. Don't pick it up.
That's why I didn't do it. That's why I didn't want to do it. I ain't been cooked yet.
This is a series that I'm working on right now. I call it my stained glass series.
Stained glass
series.
Because of the colors.
Yeah, it kind of looks like stained glass. And right now, I just made this yesterday. It's still pretty fragile. It's still drying out and needs to be fired. So, I make a lot of bowls. I used to be a chef as well.
Really?
And,
another thing we have in common.
And so I like utilitarian things such as bowls. And
so you can actually use this once it's fired.
This is completely functional. It's oven safe, dishwasher safe, food safe, of course, and microwave safe. If it's not red clay, that is. But some of the white clays are just fine in the microwave.
So for somebody that's never done something like this before, all levels are here.
Yes.
Advanced levels. Which you are, to the very basic level, pinch pot, which I am. You and Troy are here to help people. When we come back, We're going to get you on the wheel.
Yeah.
And you're going to show us how to
give you a demonstration.
Okay. Mm-hmm. We'll be back in a second. Okay, so we're back with Brian. What are you doing here on the wheel?
I am going to throw a bowl. And did you want me to walk you through it?
Yeah.
Okay, right now I'm pushing the clay down on the wheel to make sure it has a really good hold.
Okay, why are you wetting it?
So that the clay slides through my hand. The clay has to move through your hands, and without water, it won't move through your hands, and you'll actually lift the clay off the wheel.
Okay.
If you don't have enough water, and if it all dries out on you. So then once it's pushed into the wheel and I centered it, I'm going to start coning it up. And this process helps create the plasticity that's needed to create a form once you open it up on the wheel.
Now, how easy is it to take it down? Sorry, I remember you told me that's called taking it down.
Well,
how easy is it to take it down once you learn the technique and everything?
Once you learn how to use your whole body, it looks like I'm just using my arms, but I'm actually using my back and chest just as much. And whenever I push it down, I use my whole torso and body weight to go into it instead of just relying on my arms to do all the work.
Okay.
And that really helps. And like right now, I'm using my legs to squeeze my arms together.
Right.
Because it's a really big hunk of clay. This is a pretty big piece of clay to be throwing with.
Now, what are you gonna create?
I'll either do a platter or a bowl. I want to make another platter, but we'll see how it goes.
What are some of the hardest things, because Being Alive is a nonprofit, and this is definitely what I would consider an extracurricular program that they offer, with you and Troy being the facilitators here, how hard is it, one, to get bodies here, two, the supplies and things?
Well, getting the bodies isn't as too difficult, and you know, it's just a matter of, I think a lot of guys, they don't know what to expect. Mm-hmm. So they just come in to see what it's like, and if they feel like it's something that they might like, they stay, and if they don't, they leave. And then as far as getting supplies, that all depends on funding.
Right.
If we have a sale, and we raise some money, then a portion of that money goes to buy more supplies that are needed. And what we could use the most these days is to secure locations in order to have a studio sale so that we can sell more of our wares to raise more money.
And the cool thing about when there's a studio sale is the money comes back directly to the ceramic studio, and then a portion goes to the actual person who created the piece.
Right. We have a 50-50 arrangement. Anything I sell, I get 50% back, and I get 50% back to the studio.
Okay.
So with the hopes that we become a self-sustaining studio.
Okay. So when we come back, guys, we're going to talk a little bit about HIV and how HIV and art can be therapeutic and actually supportive for people living with HIV and AIDS. Back in a second.